football fans in Monroe County will have to wait to see their favorite football players in action. WTVA's Chelsea Brown is live with how much money a local school could lose during the wait on the sidelines.
Smithville school administrators have canceled their two first games. Three football players have tested positive. Now, I did speak with the Smithville principal about how this will impact the rest of the season.
Well, what we do over the next 2 weeks may determine whether or not we play football at all this year.
Today is the first full day of quarantine for the Smithville High School football team. 38 players are out for 2 weeks. They will return to school on September 15th.
Football is the lifeblood of what we do economically around here, and football is the sport that makes all other sports go financially.
Chad O'Brien, Smithville Attendance Center principal, says for a typical football game, ticket sales make between $3,000 and $3,500. The 25% occupancy rule would cut that profit to about $700 to $850.
So if you lose a couple of those, it adds up pretty quickly.
Boosters are also losing money from the concessions. O'Brien says concessions profits are usually higher than ticket sales. Concessions money typically goes back into the band program.
That's money, again, that's just being taken out of the, you know, the pockets of the kids or going back into the kids. So
O'Brien is working right now to determine an exact number of fans he will let back into the stands. He is working on getting measurements of the stands. According to his calculations, 18 inches equals one person.
It was pretty easy when they said two tickets per participant, but now that we're on 25%, we need to run some numbers and be a little more exact about what we're doing.
The band will be in the stands. That will take up some of the allowed 25% occupancy.
It's a community event, and we have people that haven't had a child or a grandchild play for years, but they still never miss a game, and they're here, and we want to honor that as well.
Administrators still have 2 weeks to finalize their plans before their game on September 18th.
People want certainty, and right now there just isn't any.
O'Brien says no other players or coaches are showing any symptoms.
As I was speaking to another administrator yesterday, we're all in this together. Nobody's ever tried to run a school in the middle of a pandemic.
O'Brien says he has spoken with the Amory School District about their football plans. They plan on having a separate set of stands or bleachers on the side of the field for the band, so the band does not take any of that 25% occupancy. Live in Smithville, Chelsea Brown, WTVA 9 News.